Now, we can easily express a plane with this condition here, that the inner product should be the same. So if I have this plane here, so any point on the plane has the same distance from P and from Q. So x times P equals x times Q under the inner product, and this gives us an equation for the plane. So P minus Q is then the mid-plane, called M here between P and Q. If we use two such planes, then we can express a rotation by double reflection at these planes, just as we have done it before. We don't need to change anything. And then the axis of the rotation is exactly the line of intersection of the two planes. What happens if the two planes are parallel? Then if I reflect from here to here and from here to here, I get a translation perpendicular to the planes by twice the distance of the planes. So this expresses then a kind of also an angle, a generalized angle. And the translation also, like the rotation, is expressed by the product of the two plane vectors in five dimensions. And this comes from the fact that the conformal group, C3, is isomorphic to the Sorgel group of this space here. And the Euclidean group, E3, is a subgroup of this orthogonal group, this signature 4-1, leaving the vector at infinity invariant. And so we use the Wörser, also called Clifford or Lipschitz group representation, basically to implement these groups. So a translator works like a rotor. As you see here, you see an explicit expression. So in the space groups in three dimensions, we always have these basic translations TA, BD, TC, so we don't need to mention them explicitly. This, for example, is a glide reflection, so reflecting at a plane A, and then if the vector B is perpendicular to A, it's in the A plane, and then we do a translation in the A plane that expresses a glide reflection. Here are the indices which are used to make the notation primitive. Then body-centered, hexagonally centered, that's a special thing, face-centered, rhombohedral-centered, and in one of the sides, ACB-centered, that also occurs. So that always means extra translations. And this is a basic way you relocate symmetry from the origin to the position T, using it the translators on both sides. Now here, I give you an example of this space group, so it's primitive. Then there are there are three vectors A, B, C, and they have basically 90 degree angles. And so the multi-vector generator products generate the symmetries, and here are these products. If I have the C here, this expresses a reflection, so this reflection plane, but this is lifted in the C direction with TC half, but it's still a reflection. Here, A wedge B basically expresses a rotation, but adding TC half in the direction of the axis makes it a screw. So this is a screw. Here, these are the screws, the vertical axis. And this is a reflection, the inversion. So I use A wedge B to make it nicely a bivector, then times C, that's perpendicular to A and B. So this generates the inversion here. And these asymmetric cubes with the three colored cones indicate general atoms, and we want to have some asymmetric to avoid the idea that there is kind of rotation symmetry automatically attached to them, like thinking there's an atom, but it can be an atom group, an ion group, a protein, or anything. Now, the interactive visualization software was that we use, as I have just explained, Clifford geometric algebra. We after defining these products, we use XML files to input the information about the vectors and the angles and the products of the vectors. Then we use a visual multi-vector software, KluCalc, which is a free software and uses OpenGL graphics, and you can also download it here. This is not free. Now our space group visualizes script based on KluCalc, but you can download a free demo with a dozen of groups from our homepage here. Now, some introduction about the software that's taken from the manual. So if you open the software, you have a help button, and you can have also a context help, which you see at the bottom, and you can open extra file which gives you a short presentation on how to use it. And here you see the basic elements. Here is a space group selection panel, basically, and here's the main visualization window. Here you get the international number, the international name, and then the geometric name and the crystal class. And here you have some elements to manipulate the view. So the elements to manipulate the view is you can show these atomic symbols, the general positions or not. You can vary the size. You can show the lattice or not. You can increase the lattice size from one cell to up to five cells in every direction. You can click on and off this triplet of vectors. You can change their lengths and their angles. And when you have reflection planes, they may cover the whole view, so you can shrink them to look in between the reflection planes. And that basically explains how to select a group. So you select the class of the crystal, the family of the crystal, and then, for example, cubic, and then you take a crystal class which corresponds to a point group, and then you get a list. This is not complete here. Nowadays it's complete. A full list of the space groups which are affiliated with this crystal class's point group by adding various translations. And then when you have this full view for complex space groups, sometimes it's hard to find what is where, what element is where, because there are so many and the view may be cluttered. So you have a rich menu of selecting, for example, only rotation, then only rotations of a certain angle, or only rotation axes which appear in a certain place in the crystal cell, or you can select them also by a geometric algebra generator one by one if you want. Yeah. You have 3D mouse interaction. If you have a conventional mouse, then that's how you need to work. You need to use this whole shift key to get the third direction, which you don't have here. But if you love computers and know that there's a 3D mouse and you use the 3D mouse, the newest demo version has an interface for the 3D mouse as well. And on the top, there is a drop-down menu, which has these options, full screen, orthographic view. This is very important for the crystallographers to compare with their tables, because they always have only orthographic projections. Then you can animate the Loci symmetry so that Locis really move, the general positions, which we call Loci for short, really move according to the symmetry transformation. You can animate a scene rotation to get a better three-dimensional impression. And then if you manipulate the view a lot, you may want to reset it because you want to see the full picture perhaps again. And then you have various lighting schemes from a relative position central lighting or ambient light. It also depends how much you want to see and how much contrast and space effects you want to have. And then you can interact with the international tables online. If your university has purchased a license, you can open them. And so that would look like if you open them, and then you get a list of space groups. And if you select here in the space group visualizer, you see the same space group appear here. So we have linked the two. If you have this on your computer and you have internet access and you have a license for it, then you can navigate on both sides. So even if in the space group visualizer we select a different space group, here automatically the homepage of that space group will also be opened. And so the space group tables, the international tables, basically look like this. So if you want to understand what these symbols are, you have to read a long legend to understand them. And then you get this list of general positions, and they basically tabulate all the positions which you see here by these small general elements, etc. Now, my talk is not finished. I just rush you through because later I really want to show you the software. as much as possible. But always please feel free to interrupt me with questions. It's an intermediate conclusion, so to say, because what I really want to show you, you will see soon. So we use geometric algebra within the conformal model of R3 to represent 2D, 3D point groups and space groups. And this is done only by selecting physical vectors from the crystal cell, from the lattice. It is interactive software. And in the future, we hope there's an ongoing discussion with crystallographers to suitably combine it officially with the international tables of crystallography. But the final word is not yet said, and it may take a few months more, I don't know. Then crystallographers also suggested to visualize extraordinary space group orbits. And they asked us, what about subperiodic space groups? And we are working on that. And I think also magnetic space groups can be very nicely shown in with such a software in the future. And also a geometric algebra representation is feasible, I think. And then there may be other additions, like, for example, instead of these general elements, to have molecules, taking molecule data from a database or ion groups. So one might think in the future to add such a toolbox, so to then really see the physical crystal plus the full symmetry which we can see already. One of my students developed, also using Klukalk, a protein visualizer. And so one idea would also be, for example, to combine such a protein visualizer and see protein crystals. So the possibilities to do more are rich. So as for more information, here's my homepage, the homepage of Kiel, where Christian worked before going to Bosch, and that's also still online. Then something which is complete and you get completely for free is just a 32 point group visualizer, so it's visualizing all the point groups in three dimensions that you can also download from this homepage. Now here the literature, and this was the paper, the Agaxe paper of David, point groups and space groups in geometric algebra, and last year followed this paper, the crystallographic space groups in GA. There was some earlier, but my feeling is incomplete work in Mexico, supervised by Keller, and these are the international tables I have referred to. Then literature, which in the course of the last 4 years we have produced on this topic. And in particular, I recommend this one. It has nice pictures, and you can download it from my homepage, which is given here, The Hidden Beauty of Gold. So I don't tell you more, look at it, and I hope you enjoy it. Then literature on the conformal model, especially here, this paper by Hastings, Lee, and Rockwood on new algebraic tools for classical geometry appeared in 2001. And yesterday, someone asked me about this issue of GANet and GANet updates. So there are two homepages I recommend to you. This is a traditional GANet email newsletter homepage, but this doesn't. So the news which I get don't come out immediately here, because I collect them and send them out when I think it's enough and when I have enough time. But in the meantime, I started this blog here. And so when I get information, as I usually put out the information on the same day on this blog. Nowadays, I periodically collect the information from the blog and put it into this email newsletter form. So if you want to have immediate information, it's best to go here. If you just remember GANet updates, and you will find it. And nowadays it has an option. You can go to the homepage of the blog and subscribe. And if you subscribe here, it's a bit different from subscribing here. If you subscribe here, then for every new message, you will get an email. So if you really want to have all the information right away, you can subscribe here. If you don't want so many emails, you can subscribe here. I'm thinking still about better options in the future.